Look, I think anytime there's a coaching change of somebody who I've had history with, it's a little bit disappointing, right? Because that means it didn't work out for whatever reason. I think that it's interesting that he ends up being the one, I guess, in essence, that has to fall on the sword. He's the one that's going to have to take the brunt of the blame now for this team not getting to where it expected to get to. But when you look at the way that this team finished the season offensively, I would argue that the offense was playing pretty well. We had Derek Carr being protected. We were throwing the ball down the field. Our offense was scoring points. So while he's going to be the one that's going to get a lot of the blame, I do not believe that the issue with this team at the end of the season, at least, was its offense. Now, I do believe that Pete is very reserved. And I think that today's personality of player is very boisterous, it's very emotional, very guys that have big personalities. So if you've got somebody that's a little more introverted leading that group, I think it could be tough to get through from time to time. So with them making a change, I think the change will have to come with somebody that has a bigger personality, somebody who is a little more boisterous, who is not afraid to stand in front of the men and command greatness from them. And I think that Pete is a guy that has been around a long time and has got a great creative offensive mind, but for whatever reason did not totally evolve. Not saying that he should have done away with the offense that we ran for so many years to great success, but I do think that the offenses that are the best in the National Football League today are the ones that have evolved. They do different things and they keep defenses off balance. They give them so many different things to think about. And I think that our offense was very, very vanilla. But I do think that he'll have opportunity beyond this. Denver obviously comes to mind for obvious reasons. But I do think that getting a fresh perspective, getting a new and fresh offense could benefit this group. And as obviously a former player and a fan of this team, I hope that it does.
I'm not sure we need anything else. I'm just going to ask you one thing here, okay? Because that was perfect. We could just pull out of that. We've been throwing names out left and right, okay? Obviously, there's one. Look, you played with Mark Brunell. He's the quarterback's coach in Detroit. I feel like, kind of following up on what you said, even if it's not the big personality, so to say, a dude who's been there, done that at that level, that knows, that commands respect, right? Like, you played with him. If it's him or Brian Griese or somebody that's a former player, do you think that could work?
Well, it's funny you say Mark Brunell because I just literally got off another Zoom call talking about where this offense could potentially go. And while I didn't say it, Mark Brunell was probably the first name that came to my mind. And with a former player, there's a whole different level of respect. Just off the rip, there's a different level of respect. Somebody that's been there and done that and led a group before, I think would command respect from everybody. And he's probably not the biggest personality, but he does know how to command a room. He was a quarterback for a long time in the National Football League. He knows how to speak to and communicate with the men. He's obviously done a great job in Detroit. I just think that, Jared Goff was a good player with the Rams, but he's taken a whole different step or another level to his game in Detroit. And we'd be foolish to think that Dan Campbell was the only reason for that. I do think that he would be a great fit. There's obviously history there with him. I don't know what offense he would run, right? But I know that he's been around the game long enough and he's running a pretty good offense there in Detroit right now. Shoot, I would love for him to come back into the building and be the guy that kind of rights the ship with this offense and gets the most out of Derek Carr. I think we saw some of the positivity or some of the greatness that is within him, but we need to see that on a consistent basis. And whoever the coach is that comes in is going to be somebody that needs to pull that from him weekly.
Lance, do you think they need to go outside the building or promote from within would be fine if they did Ronald Curry, or they just why do
I
you need to
think
go fresh?
I think they need to do a great job of figuring out what their vision is for the offense. And then you bring in a coach or you promote a coach that shares in a similar vision. Because I think it's bigger. I think the issue is bigger than just this offense going into next season, right? I think there's so many things going around or going on within that organization. You've got to have somebody that shares a vision for the direction of the team and the offense. And I think that's going to be a process to which they're going to have to do several interviews to figure out exactly what is happening in the near future and then what they could see or forecast happening in years to come. They all got to be on the same page. I do know that. And it looks and feels like an organization right now that doesn't have a surefire plan of what they're going to do in the future. So hopefully they figure that out. And hopefully the guy that they bring in can help springboard them forward into a more positive 2024 than what we saw in the last couple of seasons.
All right, Lance, that was like amazing.